Let's take a look at how to create this ring. Whenever I tackle a modeling problem, usually the first thing that I would ask is what is the overall body shape. It is quite apparent that these faces are created by cuts. So let's imagine this body without the cuts. This face looks like it can be created by a revolve. So I started out with a sketch here that is composed of two arcs and two straight lines to complete the profile. Let's revolve this profile into a solid. After doing this, I realized that this does not give the top face that we need. If you look more closely at the top face, it is a square with rounded corners. A revolve will not be able to achieve this face. It looks like we need to create a transition between a revolved face and a top face. This is going to require a loft. Now that we have decided on a loft, we need to decide how much of the revolved face we need. After trying out a few different extents, I found that a relatively small bottom works to give a good result. You can experiment with different extents on your own. I have prepared a sketch here. Let's use this sketch to create a revolved solid. Go to Create, Revolve. Select the profile. And select the y-axis as the axis of rotation. I have prepared a sketch here that represents the top face. It is simply a square with fillets. Usually, I would discourage the use of fillets in sketches, but in this case, they are essential to create a smooth loft. Go to Create, Loft. Loft from the top face of the revolved body to this sketch. To create a smooth transition to the base, you will want this to be tangent. For the transition at the top, set to connected. We want this lofted body to merge with the base, so set operation to join. From here, we can use this sketch to create an extruded cut. Mirror this cut. Create a sketch on the right plane. Select this face and project. Create an offset of this projected profile. Use this sketch to create a cut. will extend type set to all. Another option is to use a shell command. Go to Modify, Shell. Select these faces and adjust the thickness. This method actually hollows out the body all the way through to the top. If this is how you want to use a ring body, this can be a good alternative. Instead of using solid operations, we can also build surface bodies. Activate the Surface tab. We are going to use the same sketch as before for the revolve. Remove the chaining option and select the arc as a profile. From here, we can create a surface loft. The steps here will be the same as when we created the solid loft. You just need to take note to do this in the Surface tab. From here, instead of performing an extruded cut, we will be trimming the surface bodies. I have prepared this sketch beforehand. Go to Modify, Trim. Select this sketch as the trim tool. And select the surfaces to remove. Go to Create, Thicken. Select these two surface bodies to thicken and set the thickness. At this point, these are still two separate surface bodies. By setting operation to join, these bodies will merge after the thickening.